Did you know that there are different versions of Confluence? Well, I certainly didn't. When I started using Confluence, I just thought it was Confluence. And then I quickly learned that there are different versions of it. So here, we're going to just go over what the current tiers and versions are so you can understand the differences. So when you are in Confluence, you aren't as confused as I was. At its highest level, there's two main types of Confluence. There is cloud, which is hosted by Atlassian, so your team doesn't have to worry about managing servers or backups or anything. And then there's data center, where you actually host Confluence on a data center, something like AWS, which gives you more control over the servers and backups. Now you might ask yourself, why would I want to have to deal with servers and backups and things? And the answer typically is in environments that require more regulation or more specific controls. Think government entities might not be able to host something in the cloud, so they have to use a data center. So it gives your team more control. You can control the version of Confluence you're running because you can choose to upgrade it or not. Whereas on the cloud, you have the latest and greatest all the time. Most companies I happen to work with have chosen the cloud. However, in one instance, we were on data center because we needed the flexibility to control more things in a more fine-grained manner than cloud allowed. So that's the biggest division, data center or cloud. But even within cloud, there is some variation. So we're going to dig in and see what the four tiers of cloud Confluence are so you can understand the differences and make the best choice for you and your team. Here we are on Confluence's pricing page, and this shows us the four tiers of cloud right at the top. We'll start with the free one. And free is great. It lets you just spin up an instance of Confluence and start using it. I always recommend this as a starting point for someone who wants to learn Confluence because it's your own copy. You can do anything you want. And you can also have up to 10 users in there with you. So this might be very good for a small team who works well together or just needs a place to host and collaborate on information. Now, you do get some things like these unlimited pages and spaces, so there's no limit to the amount of content you can add. You get all the great templates. And the first limitation you'll run into are the number of whiteboards. I personally really like whiteboards. They're a great way to collaborate on a virtual whiteboard. But here, you only get 3 per user. This might not be too big of a deal if you aren't using too many whiteboards, but I can easily see teams running into this limit when they have multiple areas they want to use whiteboards on. You do also have the ability to add apps and other integrations, and you're limited in support. There is no support team for the free tier. It is free after all, but you can, of course, go into Atlassian community and ask for help or chat with folks there. So that might be one consideration. If your team might need more help, the free tier might not be the way to go. And the last limit that we'll really call out is only 2 gigabytes of file storage. So if you're going to be putting a lot of files in Confluence, this tier probably isn't for you. Now, if I scroll down, I'm going to see a much more detailed explanation of everything. There's another big call out in the free tier is there's no page or space permissions. Everything is just open. So I can't restrict content in the free tier. This will be a big consideration as sometimes you want to hide or restrict edit access to things. And we can't archive pages either. So our ability to manage the space that we have will be a bit limited because we don't have a lot of the great tools that the higher tiers have. And this extends to other things like there's no analytics. We don't have the ability to use automations or calendars within Confluence. And some of our admin controls are also limited. Again, this is a free instance. It's intended for small groups with limited feature set. So for what it is, it's great. I really appreciate it. However, if you're looking for a little bit more, you need those page restrictions, or you need to share things externally, which is something that the free tier can't do, you're going to have to go with Standard, which is the next level up. Standard has everything in free, all those pages and everything. But a big difference is you can share content externally to your instance. You can have guests, or you can have anonymous access. So this lets you share things like release notes or FAQ with the general public on the internet, and they can go in and get that information from Confluence. Another big one for me is you have page permissions. You can restrict the ability to edit or view a page as you need to. So many teams I work with use this quite a bit. You don't want someone just going in and changing your HR policies, so you need this tier or higher to do that. You get a ton more storage. I personally don't run into the storage limits too much. Most of my attachments are in different systems, but this greatly expands it. And another big plus for many teams is you actually get support. So between 9 to 5, you have support teams who can help you out if you run into problems or need some help. And there's no user cap. So however many users you want to add, you can. Now, note that you do pay by user. So if I change my team size up here to, say, 1,000, I'm paying $6 per person, but there's no limit to the number of people I can add. So as my team grows, I can just keep adding people. Getting more granular, we're still limited to those three whiteboards. So this could be a challenge for some teams. If you're whiteboard heavy, this might not be the best tier, but you do get access to archiving and then page insights. So you get some more analytics information, which is great for managing things. Now, that said, you don't get full-on analytics. So if you're looking for a way to keep track of who's coming to this page or how many views has it had, might not be the way to go. You also don't get all of the administrative features that Premium or Enterprise have. Again, Standard is intended for smaller teams or less complex environments. So there's some things you won't be able to do as an administrator that might make it challenging. You do, however, get some back-end, like compliancy-related items. You get audit logs, and you can also tell them where your data should live. So if you're on the free version, Confluence will just put your data somewhere in the cloud, and it could be in a country or region that isn't inappropriate for your use. However, with Standard and Higher, you can ask Atlassian, please only put it in North American data centers or only in Asian data centers, etc. So those are some of the big differences with Standard. The next level up, they call Premium. And this is typically the tier that groups I work with happen to be on. And Premium is where a lot of the newer features are unlocked. You get things like Atlassian Intelligence, which is a great tool. I found it useful for searching and also for like summarizing really long pages. That said, it's not absolutely necessary to use Confluence, but it does help bridge the gap for a lot of folks. And you also get automations, and these can be incredibly helpful. Common tasks like archiving old pages, checking things based on label, taking other actions that you do on a regular basis, you can automate at the premium tier. So before that, you're stuck manually doing all of these tasks. You also get unlimited whiteboards. So you don't have that three whiteboard per user limit anymore. You can have as many as you need. So if you're like me and you just keep making more and more whiteboards, this is the tier to go. And this is also where your administrative controls really kick in a little bit more. So again, premium for me is a divider between a larger, more mature company and maybe a smaller one. And that's not a bad thing. They're just saying that we're going to put all those features at the premium tier. Your storage is unlimited, and you also have 24/7 support for what they call a critical issue. So if your Confluence site is completely down, that would fall into this. So that's a kind of a great peace of mind for teams. This is also the first tier that has a guaranteed uptime. You'll notice the other tiers don't have any guarantee, so they could go down at any time as Confluence is balancing or changing things. As we scroll down, again, we get that Atlassian Intelligence, unlimited whiteboards, and then we see the differences down at the bottom here. All of these checkboxes, again, you get analytics, which in bigger environments is incredibly useful as you're digging into what's going on in my instance, who's seeing what pages aren't being used. You can also inspect permissions, which this is a very useful feature if you have a lot of folks going in and adding restrictions or changing things around. This helps you diagnose why can't Sally see this page. And there's some other tools like bulk archival. You can bulk archive multiple pages. Again, making it easier on your administrators. You don't have to go through one at a time. And the next big one are these automations. Again, you can automate tasks in Confluence. And for me, this is a huge time saver. I don't have to regularly go in and archive old pages. They're just automatically gone. There's also a whole host of administrative controls that we get now. Things like the ability to copy permissions between spaces. Very useful in larger environments as more spaces come online. You have a nice announcement banner that can sit at the top of Confluence. And again, just sharing information if a critical system's down or if there's a important holiday coming up, that kind of thing. You also can allow IP allow listings. So you can restrict the ability to access Confluence from only certain IP addresses. Again, not something that smaller groups wouldn't necessarily care about, but this can be important from a security perspective. You only want people coming through your VPN or in your office to be able to get in. So that was premium. And again, this is where I tend to be working in my professional life. It's got a lot of the features that I need as an administrator on a space level to keep things moving, and also unlimited use for my users to go in and make whiteboards and do things. The next step up is enterprise. And this is kind of everything. This is every feature. This is every administrative control. It's the highest tier. That doesn't mean it's the best. It depends on what we need it for. But some big things to call out, much more analytics. So again, think thousands of users in Confluence. You want to track what's going on, and you can now connect this information to other Atlassian tools. You get additional administrative controls. Again, very useful in big environments. You want to control who's going in and doing things, so you might need this. More control over how people can log in. Unlimited automations. The standard tier is limited to only 1,000 per month. I rarely run into that. However, in enterprise environments, you might need more capacity to do automations because there's so much stuff going around. You can also add different instances of Confluence at enterprise. And this is where it gets a little bit interesting for me. If your company's big enough, you may have specialized parts of it that need their own copy of Confluence. One that is completely segregated and different from all the other ones to keep it safe and secure. And so here you can have up to 150 of them. So maybe your research and development team has an instance that no one else can see just to ensure that that information is secure and safe. You also get more enhanced support. So 24/7 support for every issue, not just those critical. And their SLA is even higher here. It's 3 9s and a 5. So a little bit better guarantee that you're not going to crash randomly at night. Taking a look at the features, the biggest difference is the number of sites. Again, you can have more than one, which is nice. Otherwise, it's the same as premium, but then you get the enterprise data and insights. So if this is something your team needs, the ability to connect Confluence data with other parts of Atlassian and find some way to report on it, enterprise is the way to go because it's the only tier that has it. Your administrative controls are also enhanced a bit. You can have product requests so people can request to add different products to Confluence, and also user counts, which just help you manage everything. And your security and compliance is also expanded. Again, Confluence at the enterprise level has to support a wide range of things, so you get better audit logs. You can have different identity providers. And you can also use different types of encryption to make sure your data is super secure, something that might not be a concern for, you know, lower tiers or smaller companies. So that is the cloud version of Confluence. It's not that one is better than another. They just are different tools for different needs. Again, typically, I tend to see most groups using premium because that's where a lot of the features are unlocked. However, I've seen groups be very successful on standard and free. It depends entirely on their size. Now, the other thing to talk about is Datacenter. And you'll notice it's kind of hidden on this page. We have to hit show more to see information. But again, this is the self-managed option. This is where we would install a version of Confluence on a set of servers we control somewhere. However, that means we get complete control of the environment. We can control when it's spun up, what resources it has, what version it's running on. This does mean we have to have someone who can manage it. So typically only larger companies would be using Datacenter because they have to have a structure internally to support it. Atlassian isn't going to manage it for us. So Datacenter or DC is a great option if you have specific environments that require the control or specific versions of Confluence. However, for most groups, most of the time, that cloud version is going to be best because you don't have to think about the technical back end of supporting everything in Confluence. So those are the versions of Confluence currently available. I hope you found this useful. If you did, please subscribe and like. That really helps me out. And please drop your questions or concerns down there in the comments. I'll be happy to answer them. Thank you so much for taking time to learn with me, and I'm looking forward to seeing you in another one of these again soon.